banned by the NDC for undermining the Parliament of the Republic of Ghana is very dangerous for our democracy. Parliaments are the unique institutions that distinguish democratic governments from non-democratic governments. Under military dictatorships and so on, the judiciary is there, there's always cabinet, there's executive. But dictatorships don't have parliaments. So parliaments are a very unique feature of democratic societies and must be guarded jealously and respected. Now, this is the second time that a document goes to the House of the Representatives of the People, and then NDC elements in that parliament rush these documents to the media, to social media, to public spaces, in order to either undercut, undermine, or destroy the credibility of the debate and discussions that will be going on in that parliament. How can you be a member of parliament and be leaking documents that are meant for discussion in that parliament to the press in order to, if you want, generate public discourse and, if you want, excite opprobrium for the government of the day? When you do that, you are undermining the very house from which you derive your legitimacy as a participant in our democratic process. Because what is your legitimacy? Your legitimacy is that you are an NDC member of parliament. So if there is no parliament or the credibility of parliament is destroyed, your legitimacy as a human being in our democratic process is also gone. And therefore, I'm just using this opportunity to call on the NDC to be decorous, to begin to respect the sanctity of parliament. That when a document, when government takes a document to parliament, because that document, from what the minister has been saying, has been in this ministry for more than 8 months. That's number one. And we have operators in this ministry. They didn't leak it to the press. After that, it went to cabinet and stayed around the cabinet secretariat for another maybe four months or whatever. And the day that we take it to parliament, in order for the representatives of the people to discuss it, NDC elements in the parliament then take the document, photocopy it, and throw it into the public space when even the debate in parliament has not started.